It's perfect. It's like a poster for a wall.
It is a nice cover, isn't it?
It's perfect-ish.
Ah, I like what you did there.
That actually is exactly what the author Jess Seaborn did. She made it into a poster because it is a cool cover. And perfect-ish is almost perfect for the walls because that's what it's about, life being
perceived,
pretended to be.
Obviously, with the advent of social media, everyone seems to be highlighting their best life. Hashtag living their best life. And Prue is just about to turn 30, and she seems that everyone else is living their best life apart from her because she's going through a bit of a rough trot in her own personal life. She's abandoned her university degree. She's lost a job. She's worked at
wedding
a council.
Didn't happen. The wedding didn't happen. So, but everything, she's reading all of her friends and everything. Hashtag celebrating our beautiful hand, not celebrating my whiplash. Done too many flicks of my
hair. I like how you talk like that too.
I know you feel like when you read hashtags, that's how it feels. It's a little bit like, you know, if you look at your Instagram feed right now, everyone you know is in Europe. Having a great holiday.
I'm here, obviously.
Well, no, some people have been in Europe, hashtag chasing the bulls.
I look at some of these quotes and I sort of cringe because I thought, I've sort of said a few of these quotes, haven't I?
Hashtag best life.
Oh, it's a bit embarrassing, isn't it?
But it is unfortunately the world we live in now, and people, plenty of people not being authentic because they're trying to convince themselves life is good. And so it tells one of those tales, and I think it's a really interesting take. Like when I was this age, turning 30, you know, I was living with girlfriends watching Ally McBeal and Sex and the City, right? And that was kind of, that's where we got our outlets, whereas now people are all turning to each other and jealousing over everybody's lives.
Well, there was no documentation of all of your highlighting. We might have taken a photo here and there, but we weren't...
On film.
Yeah, on film, and then we'll take a week to process it and then show it at some birthday party. So everything is documented and everything is shown. So it seems like this is a really good book because it just highlights the fact that you might have a good life, but you look at everyone else's life and comparing. Anyway, Prue is turning 30.
Yes, and so she's a whole bunch of stuff hasn't happened for her, right?
Yeah,
so her best friend Delia, who I quite love Delia, but you know, I don't think Delia's life is quite as shiny and glossy as it all seems as well. Delia writes this great big list for her to put on the fridge in the house she lives in with her brother, and she kind of whittles it back to three.
Yeah, you know, well, she's got to ditch a job, move out of her brother's house, and also find love. I like the book also because it works its way through a whole year. You start off in January and end up in December, so it works through each sort of month. And I think the first pages of each month is actually really gets you in, doesn't it? And it's sort of like an anti-romcom. It's not
That's a really good description, actually. Jess Seaborn's a lovely tale of...
She's a local girl. She's a Brizzy girl.
Great tale of persistence and perseverance because this was a book she was doing during COVID times and lockdown times, and she wrote it and rewrote it and wrote it and rewrote it and rewrote it, then ended up with a two-book deal. So it's probably not a book written for you, but you're okay because her dad gave it the tick of approval.
It did. Obviously, she's documented her whole process on writing the book, which I found really, really interesting, you know, scrolling through her socials. But I did find something really interesting that she wrote, her dad wrote, because, you know, you give your book to your parents and your family members to read.
What do you think?
And he said this, her dad, 189 pages into your book. Obviously, I'm not your target audience, but I enjoy that there is very few characters, and even I want to keep reading and finding out if their life goes on to the crapper or the chateau. I believe your target audience will love it. Well done, Jess. I've got to finish it before your mum takes it up the coast to read.
My dad, don't you love it? That's awesome.
That's great.
And I reckon that's how you'll feel about it. There's, you just kind of, it's a time in life we've been through or you're going to go through, and they're living a different life these days. And life doesn't have to be perfect. It can be perfect-ish.
Well done, Jess, on your debut and all.
Yeah.